Well, one is that older people are automatically all sick and senile, which is not true. Only about 5% of older people, for example, are in nursing homes with any kind of a dementia or Alzheimer's disease. The idea that they're unproductive and can't be successful in the workforce, when we know there are numbers of them that are, and they're very dependable and hardworking people in the workforce. The idea they're all sexless, which is also not true. They have desire, capability, and satisfaction, unless they have a disease of some sort. And even those are now increasingly treatable. They're still capable of learning. And, right now, there are already 74,000 centenarians. That means people over 100 years of age. And they have remained independent and capable up through their 95th year. So there's no way to assume that people are not able to learn just because they're getting older. Well, it's built into their central nervous system, and it simply hasn't played out as yet. I suppose if you had the 200-year-old person, maybe they would have trouble, but we don't know that yet. Well, I think one of the great ways to do it is to learn something totally different, like a new language, a musical instrument, because that really challenges the brain. And learning more of the same, like continue to do crossword puzzles, might be okay, but it's not as desirable or as powerful a stimulant to the central nervous system as a brand new challenge, like a new language or a musical instrument. Well, the capacity for learning new things, vocabulary building, judgment actually grows with age. Speed changes. That is, you're not as quick in responding to a stimulus as you get older.